Afternoon, everybody. Formally, this is our last Adobe Express session of the Educator session of 2024. My name is Martin Coutts. I am one of the education officers with the Digital Learning and Teaching team here at Education Scotland, and I am just being the MC for this particular session. We are delighted once again to be welcoming our friend from Adobe, Meredith Jones, who's going to be taking you through all of the cool things that you can do with Adobe Express. I think he's got a couple of things up his sleeve. This session is being recorded, so just kind of bear that in mind. Cameras and mics, you can take them off, but just bear in mind that that will come on camera. The best way is probably to use the chat and to use reactions. So reactions have been enabled, where if you've got something that you're wanting to say or do, you can, you know, it's a good indication for us to know whether everything's okay. But with that, I will hand over to you, Meredith, and let you get cracking on with this afternoon session. Once again, thanks for coming along and thanks for doing this, buddy.
Hey, no worries. Thank you very much, MC Martin Coutts. So I like that, Martin. Right, so welcome into you guys. Welcome back if you've been to one of these sessions with either me or with Dom, my colleague before. Thanks for coming along. It's always a long old term, this first term of the year, and I'm sure you are exhausted and ready for your Christmas break. Not too far to go, but it must feel like a mountain with everything else that's going on in the next couple of weeks, I'm sure. So hopefully we can help you out, because we've put together a whole set of Christmas challenges, and the idea with these Christmas challenges is to make them really easy for you to get using them in class, is that it's kind of self-serve. Okay, so we've got this challenge page put together. I've put the link in the chat, so it's just bit.ly/expresschristmas. So this is kind of a traditional challenge page that we'd set up for our live lessons. If you've come along to any of our live lessons, this will be familiar to you, where we usually just have two challenges, so kind of challenge one and then challenge two. But as you can see, we've added loads more challenges in to the challenge page for the Christmas challenges. So there's tutorial videos there. So we're going to have a look at a couple of these today, and hopefully you'll think, oh, that's easy, and I can use that in class between now and the end of term. Also, just to make it even easier, we've actually got a lot of these challenges and some other different ones built into the app itself. So you may notice when you log into Adobe Express that your dashboard looks a bit different. The Adobe Express homepage looks a little bit different. And over here on the left-hand side of the homepage, you've got this jump into the 12 days of creativity. So if you click view all on that, then you actually got in here 12 guided activities. So we'll have a quick look at how they work today as well. So it's not just a tutorial video, so it's kind of helps your students a little bit more again than just the tutorial videos that we normally share with you. It'll actually walk them step by step through an activity. For example, if I open this one up, you've got the learn panel on the right hand side, and then it takes you through the steps, and they just click through and they can follow along at their own pace. So great if you want your learners to do some independent learning, to explore the app and explore their creativity a little bit more as well. All right, I've got the chat open. So if you've got any questions, I try to remember to glance over at it now and again. So if you've got any questions, then just fire them into the chat, and I'm happy to take this off on a tangent. If somebody wants me to go over something specific, just let me know. Okay. Also in the chat there, I've got our normal links. So that's bit.ly/express links. So if you've just heard me talk about live lessons and you have no idea what I'm talking about, then we run weekly live lessons. And the whole idea with that is that you pop the live stream up on your whiteboard. All the kids in the class are logged in to Express, and then we just lead them through different activities based on calendar events. Okay, so we've actually got four Christmas live lessons coming up where we'll be going through some of the things that you're going to see this afternoon, and then we're going to have a whole menu of events coming up ready for you in January through, well, we do them all the time. So it's every week. Right. Quick introduction. My name is Meredith. So you may have picked up on the accent. I'm based down here in Southwest Wales. I've been working for Adobe nearly for a year. I started back on January the 2nd. And before then, I was a teacher in a secondary school, a Welsh language secondary school down here in Carmarthenshire for 17 years. And before then, I was a peripatetic music teacher working mainly with primary schools. So I've done a lot of work across all the age ranges. And Express is something that came to us in Wales through Hub, our version of what you've got in Glow, just when the pandemic hit. And it was transformative in the way that we were able to get digital skills out across the curriculum at our school. So hopefully your journey is going to be as exciting as that. Okay, let's have a look at our first challenge then. So here we go. We're on the challenge page. If you want to get to here, as I said, bit.ly/expresschristmas, bring you to the challenge page. So this first challenge is a nice, easy one. If you may have noticed that a lot of the stuff we do, we start from scratch. We'll start with an empty canvas. So if you'd like an easier start, then this challenge actually uses a template, okay? And so all you need to do is get your learners to click on this click here button, and it'll open up this snow globe. You're going to snow globe yourself. Make a snow globe about you and your interests. So we're going to click there where it says click here. And that's going to open up the example snow globe on Express. And then so you could just share that page with your learners, or you could share this link with your learners so that when they get here, that's all they have to do is click on this blue button down in the bottom right-hand corner that says remix this design. So I'm going to click on that. And it's basically just going to open that project up in Express. Okay. So here it is. Here's the project. This is Jenna's globe. So if I click play down here on the timeline, there we go. I can see Jenna's snow globe, and there we are. So this is a really nice activity because your learners aren't going to have to build it from scratch. Okay, and if you want them to do something nice and quick, but it to be personal for them, then a lot of this stuff is all ready to go. Okay, so what can we do then to personalize this? Well, first of all, I suppose I definitely want this to be my name. So you can see there. So what you're going to be teaching your kids, your learners, your students in this activity is to be able to use the layer stack over here on the right-hand side. Okay, so we've got the layer stack on the right-hand side. And what I'm doing is kind of selecting things, and I'll be swapping them out for things that are relevant to me and my interests. So the first thing I want to swap is the name in this text box. So if I just click on that, there it is. And now I can just double click in there and I can replace Jenna's name with mine. That's great. Now, if you're not fussed on that font, then obviously you can do things like change the font. And, you know, I would definitely encourage my learners to kind of personalize their globes so that it reflects their personality, and the kind of font that we like do reflect our personalities. We've all got a favorite font, right? And we've all got a font that we hate as well. So there we go. So there's my text set. So you can see how this is a new way of working. It's a different way of working rather than starting from scratch. Okay, so let's get into the snow globe itself. So you can see here in the layer stack. So this layer here is the actual snow globe. So I'm not going to be swapping that. I'm going to keep that as it is. But there's a picture here of Jenna. Okay, so we're definitely going to swap that. So if I click on that picture of Jenna, you'll see that we've got this replace button up here. Okay, this replace button. Or when it's selected, it also hovers above the image there. It says replace there. Both of those buttons will do the same thing. Okay, so if I click on one of them, I've got these options. I can then upload a photo, or I can search for a photo. So you can search for something that represents them, their favorite animal, favorite place, or as I said, if they've got some photos on their device, they could upload them. So I've got a photo, I think, in my drive. So let's just click on upload from device. And I've got it in here. And there it is. Okay. So there we go. So it brings it in, and I think I need to remove that background. Okay, I need to remove that background. So I'm going to click on the remove background tool here on the left hand side. There we go. And it's done. Okay, cool. So let's just have a look at how this video is looking so far. Okay, I've got the timeline here and I've got the playhead. This black line shows me where I am in the timeline. So I'll bring that back to the start and I'll click play. And you can see that that photo of Jenna had this animation preset on it where the photo's kind of jittering around. So I've kept that on there. And also the photo of Jenna was slightly... We can see other layers of in front of it. So we've got some opacity going on there as well. So when you replace an image, it kind of inherits all of the effects that you've added to the original image. Okay, that's great. I'm happy with that. Brilliant. Now then, maybe I'll want to send it back in my layers, but I'll sort that out later on. Now then, what about these stars? I do like these stars. They are very Christmassy, but I want this to be all about me and the things that I like. So I'm going to replace these stars. So I've selected them there in the layer stack on the right-hand side. And then I'm going to click on replace here. And then let's just search maybe for music, maybe music notes. So before I kind of was teaching digital, responsible for digital skills in my school, I was a music teacher, so that's definitely something that kind of represents my interests and my personality. So you can see when you search, you've got, you know, I've got 4,121 results there, which is a lot. So you can scroll through, you can try and refine your search. This one's going to work well for me, I think. I quite like that. That's fine. So I'm going to bring that in. Now, that fits in there. That's fine. So the original stars were cropped, I think. Okay, so let's see if I can uncrop this a little bit. Yeah, there we go. I can uncrop it. And I think I also need to get rid of the background. Okay, that kind of chalkboard background that we see there. So again, I'm going to click on my image. It's not quite loaded in yet, so I can't remove the background quite yet. But once it's loaded, I can. In the meantime, I can still carry on working. Okay, so this star here, let's do something about that. Let's swap that for something else. So let's select it in the layer stack. And what am I going to go for this time? The other main interest I've got, apart from music and technology, is football. It is. So I'm going to replace it with a video. Go, and let's just search for football. There we go. Haha. Now then, being the American company that it is, maybe I should search for soccer in there rather than football. Right. Now, you can also replace images with design assets. You may notice it there. Now, design assets are great because they will usually already be cut out. They'll already have their backgrounds removed. So let's try seeing what that looks like. Okay, I'm going to click on there and use this replace button up here. And rather than replace this star with a photo, I'll choose design assets. Okay, and you can see here that we've got a load of stuff in here. And I like this kind of cartoony football here. So if I click on that, there we go. It's in. And because it's a design asset, it doesn't have a background. All right. Now then, what's coming up next? We got the Eiffel Tower here. I tell you what, let's see. Let's replace this chalkboard and try looking in design assets there for music notes as well. Ah, these are better. These are better. These are wonderful, in fact. I think I'll go with that. Yes. Oh, look at that. Oh, dear me. Wonderful. Right. So that's done. Now then, what's coming next? The Eiffel Tower. Now, I do love going to France, but I don't think the Eiffel Tower is that important for me personally. So maybe I'm going to replace that with something to do with Wales. Here. Wales. There we go. Well, there's Cardiff there. There's Conwy Castle there. Wowzers. That's St. David's Cathedral. That's the Pentre Ifan Burial Chamber there. Oh, what a wonderful place I live. Right, that's Aberystwyth. What shall I put in there? Let's put Cardiff Bay in. Let's put Cardiff. Okay, so I've got Cardiff Bay. And I'm going to remove the background from that. So let's click on it. Now then, I'd like to see maybe the old, that's it, that old city hall building. Cool. And then I'm going to remove the background there. Okie dokie. Wonderful. And let's just resize this a little bit. And let's pop it down there. Now then, I don't want all this kind of this dock size. I'm just going to crop that up like that. Brilliant. And then just kind of frame it a bit. Wonderful. Now remember that all of these photos that I've been replacing, when they were in that original template, all had they all had animations preset to them. So when I play this, there we go. You see my notes are kind of swirling around and my football is swirling around and I'm there jiggling about as well. And then we've got this wonderful kind of snowing scene thing going on in the front as well. So you don't have to get, you know, really involved in animating stuff. Now, if your learners want to tweak those things, they can choose anything, go down to animation, and then they can decide if they want their, you know, my Cardiff City Hall to wiggle like this, then I can, or jitter, or even spin around if I want, or bob around as if it's floating on the sea. So you can add animation presets to anything. You change the ones that are already there. Now then, maybe I want to put a hat because this the top of my head is slightly chopped off here. Looks a bit funny. So let's go to elements. So you don't just replace stuff. You can also add things in to this template. Okay, you don't have to just stick to replacing the things that are there. I'm going to keep that kind of snowy background with the trees and them. I think that looks nice. That's quite cool. But you could replace that, obviously. Let's jump in and grab a design asset. Remember, the design assets are these kind of stickers. So I'm going to search for a Santa hat. Great. And let's just pop that in. So as you can see, it doesn't have a background. Now, I could just find a photo, remove the background, of course. But I think the design assets are far easier to use because you can just drop them on. And use them as they are. There we go. That's great. Now then, that's going to be staying still whilst I'm jittering around. Okay. So maybe you want to add an animation preset to that Santa hat as well. So let's check what animation preset I've got on myself. Here we go. Oh, it's a wiggle. You can see it down there. It's wiggling. So let's click on the Santa hat and let's go to animation and let's loop and let's put a wiggle on that hat as well. Right, let's try it. There we go. Now, the hat and me are kind of wiggling separately at the moment, but I think that looks quite cool. If you wanted them to move together, then it's really easy to just group things as well. Okay, so you can click, shift-click on things and group them, and that's easy to do, and then you can animate the group as one thing. Now then, I think that Santa hat is in front of everything else, so this wonderful kind of snowy overlay that we've got isn't in front of my Santa hat. So a really good skill for your learners to learn is, you know, that we pop things into their correct place on the layer stack. Right. Well, I'm really happy with that. I think it's really cool. If there's anything I don't like, it's probably kind of how straight these edges are on the bottom of my picture. It doesn't really blend very well, does it? So if you want to edit that further, let's just select that image. And we've already used remove background, but you can also use the remove tool. And this is really nice if you want to kind of soften edges. So I'm not going to use the quick selection brush. I'm going to use the circle brush and bring the hardness of that brush down. And then I can just kind of softly paint like this. I tell you what, let's bring that hardness down even more. Bring the size of the brush up. There we go. There we go. And you can see, because that the hardness of the brush has been reduced, that we've got this, I can really soften that edge at the bottom, of my image. So now that kind of cut out square lines, they don't look quite as clinical. Okay, I'm done with that. So I'm gonna click done down here. Let's have a look at my animation now. Click play. Yeah, that looks way better. Looks way better now. I'm really happy with that. And I've customized that template. And this is definitely my snow globe now. So let's name this project, because I haven't named it at all yet. But don't panic. Express is always saving everything you do all of the time. Okay, so even when you haven't named your project, once you open that project up, it'll be in your learner's My Files in Express. And if anything happens, if somebody switches their computer off by mistake or on purpose, or you lose internet connection or the Chromebook runs out of battery, when that learner logs it next in, it doesn't even have to be on the same device, there that project will be there with the last thing they did in their My Files. Right, so let's save this as Meredith Snow Globe. Great, and that is done. Now then, how does my learner get this out of Express to share it? Because it's really cool. How do we share these with the wide world? So we've got a few options. Now, some of you, I'm sure, have got kind of a school policy or a kind of school, your school's way of doing things, where maybe you store everyone's work digitally in either a Google Drive or a OneDrive, or maybe if you're a J2E school, maybe you store all their work in their My Files. So if you'd like them to kind of keep all their digital work together somewhere, like one of those places, then you can easily click on the download icon in Express, and you could download this as a video file, as an MP4. Now, the default here is to download it in the original size. Now, the original size of this is 4K, which is like super high definition, which is a bit of overkill, to be honest, and you're probably going to clog up your internet bandwidth in school. So if I was in school, I'd probably just keep that. 720 is still, it's kind of the original HD. So it's more than enough. 720 is plenty. That's what we always say on our live lessons. So if you want them to kind of drag that into their Google Drive, OneDrive, J2E, My Files, whatever, then I would just say, right, click download, change the resolution to 720, hit download, and then that's going to download that MP4 file to the device, and then obviously your learners can drag that easily from their downloads folder into wherever you want them to keep everything. Now, that's easy enough to do, but to be honest with you, there's kind of an easier way again of sharing work, which doesn't involve downloading and dragging stuff around, and that's to publish it to the internet. So basically, we've just got a view-only link option in Express. I'm just pausing for a minute because this is download. I could cancel it, but I just want you to see how quickly it will download. You know, it's not going to take forever for that project to download. It's nearly finished. So, you know, if you are getting them to download stuff, it's not as if it's going to take, you know, 10 minutes, half an hour for them to download their animation. Mine's done. Okay, and because I downloaded it in 720, you can see that it's only 19 megabytes. So that's a pretty small file size for a kind of a video file. So that's manageable. If I just downloaded that in 4K, it would probably be four times the size. Okay, so so it's worth just changing that. Now then, if you like an easier way of doing it, what we find easiest is to click on share and then share a view only link. Now, obviously, if you use Google Classrooms or Microsoft Teams with your learners, then they could hand it directly from Express into the assignment on Teams or Classroom from Express. So you can just click there, they choose the classroom, choose the assignment, hand in. But otherwise, this is lovely, view only link. When you click on that, okay, create link. And notice that little toggle there, allow others to use this. Well, that's what we followed to start working on this in the first place. So if you want to, you could actually change this template to yours. So you could have, you know, I'd have Mr. Jones's globe, and this could be me. And then I could share that link with my learners rather than the example we had. I can't remember what the name was now, Jen, I think. So rather than using the Jen example, if you want to, you could give them your globe. That's all you need to do is switch that on, allow others to use this. Okay. Is it too late for me to do it now after I've clicked? Maybe. We'll see. And again, this takes about as long as it takes to download. But what it's going to do is it's going to give you a URL. It's going to give you a link. And anybody who clicks on that link will be taken to, basically, where was it? Something that looks exactly like this. Okay. So you can get your learners to publish their work like this as well. And anybody who clicks on your learner's work will see it like this animating, which is really fun. If you want them to remix yours, then it'll have that remix button. If your learners don't tick that, where's my mouse pointer gone? There it is. If your learners don't tick that, allow others to use this, then that remix button isn't there. Okay, there it is. I've got the link. Copy link. Let's see it. Paste it in. There it is. I'm really happy with that. So a really fun activity that you could kind of pass to your kids and say, right, guys, click on the link. You're going to get a template and then make it your own snow globe. If they need any help with it along the way, then on this challenge page, we've got this tutorial video that'll help them to go through it and to see what they need to do. Okay. You could even then collect them all in. You could have a kind of portfolio. You could do a digital portfolio of everyone in your class's snow globes all on one in a web page. Okay. So we've got web page building in Express. Just that share code. Use that to embed a video into a web page. Maybe I'll show you that super quick now. If you want them to maybe you want to put QR codes up on the wall saying, scan these QR codes to see our classes as snow globes. And maybe when people mention QR codes to you, it sends a shiver down your spine. You can teach your learners to make their own QR codes. Okay, it's really easy. This is how a learner would make their own QR code. They're going to publish the view only link. They're going to copy that link. So we want to turn this link into a QR code. So look how easy this is. You can teach your class to do this in 10 minutes flat. Once they've got their link copied, we're going to click on the Express icon. That's this colorful A in the top left-hand corner. Takes you back to the home page. And then I'm going to click on the plus in this purpley blue dot in the top left-hand corner. And under Quick Actions, the third button there is generate a QR code. Quick actions, generate QR code, control V to paste that in, and they've got their QR code. And if they're fussy like me, they can choose kind of different design QR codes because that makes me feel warm inside. And then just download it, and there they've got it. So you can get your learners to make their own QR codes so that you don't have to spend hours of your life doing that. Right. What about getting them as some kind of a gallery for your whole class? So if you get hold of their URLs, then that's all you need to do is build a web page, and that's out here. Okay. Now, you could get them to build a web page, but if you want to do this as a kind of portfolio of your whole class's work, maybe it's best that you make the portfolio. So just click on build a web page, just create from scratch. And in here, so we could say something like our snow globes. There we go. And this, maybe your class is by P6 and 7. There we go. Right. And maybe we want a nice Christmassy background here. So let's search for snow globe. Mm-hmm. Oh, I like that. It's not a snow globe, but it's perfect. Right. So that's my title for my web page. How easy is it to add those videos? Well, super easy. Let's just scroll down and let's just choose video. And I'm just going to paste that in there, save, and it's done. Okay. And then you could add the next learner's video by going there, play, not play, plus video, paste it in, save. Okay. So you could super quick build up. And that's what this is, what this looks like then. If we just have a quick preview, what this looks like. Oh, my video hasn't finished uploading yet. There we go. Here it comes. You've got this really cool looking kind of gallery of your whole classes, snow globes. There we go. There it is. It's a really nice way of bringing together everyone's work, kind of like a virtual gallery of their video project. Okay, I'm going to pause there. We're half an hour through. Does anybody have any questions so far on what we've done in that activity? So we've opened up a template on Express, which if you followed our live lesson before, we normally start from scratch. But again, this time of the year, you want to have some capacity for your learners to be able to work a little bit more independently, don't you? You want them to be able to kind of maybe make something their own rather than start from scratch. Because starting from scratch can be more rewarding, but it's definitely more demanding of your attention as a teacher as well. So there's a million things going on this time of year. So using templates is a nice way for your learners to be working independently. Okay. Any questions about QR codes or building a web page or anything like that? It doesn't look like it. So if you do have any questions.
No, chat seems okay. Yeah. Seems to be quite clear. I'm edited. You're explaining it all nicely.
Brilliant. Thank you. Yeah. So let's just move ahead then. So on the challenge page, you can scroll down and then there's obviously more challenges. Okay. So the second one here is decorate your favorite spot to curl up and relax with all your favorite things this Christmas. So this is a guided activity. So this is different. So this first one is a template that your learners are going to make their own. And there's a tutorial video for you there. But this is actually a guided activity built into Express. So you can click on the button, or if you're planning on getting them to do that, it's probably easier for them not to come to this bit.ly Express Christmas page at all. And you can just get them into Express and it'll be here. Obviously in January, they'll be gone, but then you're not going to be wanting to do these activities in January, will you? So you can see there, it's one of the two actual highlighted ones here, animate a cozy fireplace scene. But if you'd like to see what else is there, just click on view all. And here we go. Here are these guided activities. So let's have a look at how this works. So here it is here. It's the animate a cozy fireplace scene. Okay. So we open it up. Now it is a template again. Okay. Similar to that last template. What's different, and we can see the layer stack here, okay, same as that last template. But what's different is that we've got this learn panel. And your learners, I'm not sure if you're going to hear it now, but they can then click and it'll play them through. Oops. So you've got that voiceover giving you an introduction to the activity. And if your learner's like, yeah, that looks great, then let's click on get started. And here we go. It basically talks them through what they need to do. So here we go. Number one, first, let's add or remove items from your living room to set the scene. Photos like the chair can be swapped out using the replace button. Okay, and this is the same. This is the same skill set as you used in that first activity. You click on the chair, use the replace button, and so on. And it just walks them through it. Okay, so this is, you know, this is perfect. Again, if you want your learners to be working independently, it's going to be a lot of fun. And then they can go through and go to next and share it. And some guided activities will have more steps than others. You'll click next a few times. This one is definitely a pretty straightforward one. So I'm not going to do that now because I think that you're happy with this this kind of concept of here's a template, let's change it up. You know, you got things you've got fun things like groups in here, like this photo on the wall. So if I can ungroup that, and then I can get rid of that palm tree. And then you can obviously add, I'm zooming all over the place here. Let me just zoom back the other way. And then you can add whatever you want into that photo frame. You can change the dog, and change what the dog's playing with, change who's sitting here, what they're saying. The fireplace is a fun one. That's actually a video file that's playing in there. So if I play that, and you got that mouse scurrying along as well. So there's loads of fun stuff going on there. You may have noticed the background music. That's easy to add just by going to media and audio. And up there, you can choose from hundreds and hundreds of different background musics and background tracks. And then that can be shared in exactly the same way as that snow globe that we just saw. Okay, so again, a nice activity where, your learners are replacing things. You know, the scenery behind these windows could be something that your learners see out of their classroom window. Really nice way to personalize this. Okay, now, if you do want to do something more hands-on, then a fun activity that we've done is a jack-in-the-box. Is to make yourself into a jack-in-the-box. So this is also one of the guided activities that you can see down here. You can see it. Where is it? Oh, there it is. There we go. You can make it as a jack-in-the-box. So that's a template, but we like making stuff from scratch here as well. So let's just jump in and make something from scratch, because it feels a little bit strange for me to just use templates on a session with you guys, because I'm sure. Sure, you'll if you've seen our stuff before, we don't usually use templates. So I'm going to create a graphic. I'm going to click on this green tile. And there we are. I'm making a graphic. So if I want to make this jack-in-the-box, there's some really great graphic design skills that we can use in Express. And your kids will love doing this. Right. First things first is let's pick a color scheme. So I'm going to go to theme at the top. And you could search for just Christmas. Or you could search for winter, but Christmas gives you some interesting kind of wintry color schemes. I like that. I like those three colors there. So I'm going to choose that. There we go. And then that background color is fine. If you wanted one of the different ones, you've now got the page theme here, so you can choose from the page theme there in background color. Okay, let's make a jack in the box of me. Or my favorite animal, or whatever I want. Right. So let's make the box first of all. So I'm going to go to media, and I'm going to go to photos, and I'm going to search for something like Christmas and red. Okay. You can pick whatever color you want there, but I'm going to go for something like Christmas red. Here we go. And there's some really nice kind of seasonal looking patterns in here. The glitters are cool, but I like these snowflakes up here. Yeah, that's great. So I'm going to click on that, and there it is. Oh, right, that happens to be square anyway. If it wasn't, because a lot of these will come in as rectangles, then you can use these crop handles to just crop it to a rough square. Okay, but mine happened to come in as a square, so I didn't really need to do that. Right, there we go. There's my jack-in-the-box box. Great. Now I want the kind of jack-in-the-box lid that's flown open. So I'm going to duplicate this. Because the lid is going to be made of the same material. So I'm going to duplicate that. So three dots duplicate. So I've got two boxes now. And I'm going to just crop that down. There we go. Maybe make it smaller like that as well. And let's rotate it. Wonderful. There's one lid. And then we've got two lids. So I'm going to duplicate this. So this other one's going to go the other side. Instead of rotating it, tell you what, I'm just going to just use the flip horizontal button over here. Wonderful. There we go. And you see those pink guidelines? I'll show you again. Just helping me to get everything nice and square. Okay, so there's my jack-in-the-box box. Jack-in-the-box box. Now I need my jack-in-the-box spring. So let's just looking here for spring. Now, when I've done this before, I think I get kind of loads of, yeah, the season of spring, which feels like a million miles away at the moment. So maybe I'll just search in here for maybe metal spring, metal spring. There we go. This one's great. Bring that in. Now, you know this, you know how to remove a background. So let's just click on that, remove background. Now, if you are enjoying this one, this is a little bit of a bonus one for you guys, because, you know, you can all go through that that web page. But this is a special for you. This is, so if you want to do this, you'll need Martin's recording of this session. Okay, if you want to go through this. Right. So I've got my spring there. Remove the background. Let's pop that spring behind the box in the layer stack. There we go. Brilliant. Right. Now then, it's time to get me up there as a kind of character. So let's search in the photos for something like Christmas sweater. Christmas sweater. No, I don't actually want a sweater. I just want the pattern itself. So this argyle here would be great. This would be good as well, this kind of cable knit thing. So I'm just looking for the actual, this would be good, wouldn't it? That would be good. I'm just looking for the pattern itself, the fabric itself. I don't want an entire sweater. That argyle is lovely as well. So I think I'm going to scroll back and use that, unless something else grabs me straight away. No, yeah, I'm going to go back and get that. So I'm going to bring that in. Brilliant. Now then, I want to make this look like kind of a torso of a sweater. So I'm just going to crop it to a shape this time. Okay, now you've seen how we can crop on these straight lines, but you can also crop any image to a shape by using this crop button on the left-hand side. So when I click on that, we've got all these options. Now, none of these particularly look like a sweater, but this pentagon is going to work for me, because my head is going to hide that top point of the pentagon. So I'm going to click on that and then click away. Yeah, there we go. And that's cropped that to that shape. Now, if you don't think this looks like it's going to be a sweater, then have a bit of faith, guys. Come on. So I'm going to put it on a nice jaunty angle. It's my jack in the box. Yeah, it's a bit crazy like this. Brilliant. Now then, it's time to put some sleeves on my jumper. So instead of an image, let's just grab a rectangle this time. So I'm going to go to Elements, and I'm going to go to Shapes at the top. Okay, and I just want a plain old rectangle. This guy here, that's fine. Brilliant. Now you'll see it's using my color theme colors, which is perfect. And you know what? That green that it chose is actually the perfect color that I want. Okay, let's just change the size, spin it around, and there's my first arm there. Great. And then I'm going to duplicate that. Click on it, duplicate. And this, I just want it to go the other way. So let's use that flip like we did with the lid. Use the flip button. There it is. And now I've got the other arm over here. Now, the arms need to be, the join between the arms and the body need to be hidden. So let's just bring our main jumper to the front. So let's just use our layer stack, drag up the front. There we go. Now we've got these cool sleeves coming out there. That's great. And I think I'm wearing some gloves, some mittens. So whilst we're in Shapes, let's grab a circle. Here we go. The circle here. And again, so that's in the same color, so I'm going to want to change that. Let's use the red. Oh, I just changed the background color. What are you doing, Jones? Let's just undo that. Undo. There we go. Right. I want to change the color of the circle. I come over to the left-hand side here. Let's click on there, and we'll go for the red. Yes. Wonderful. Lovely red mittens. Now, that reminds me of something. It reminds me of a book or a cartoon, something to do with red mittens. Something to do with Christmas. If anybody knows what's just popped into my head, then please tell me, because that's just triggered a core memory. Red mittens. I can't remember. There was something from my childhood. Right. Duplicate that and pop that mitten over there on the other side. I'm having a lot of fun here. Right. Let's get ahead in there. Now, I'm going to show you two ways, because obviously maybe your learners don't have a photo of their head handy. I mean, if you've got Chromebooks or iPads with a camera built in, then that's not too difficult. Take a photo and just drag it. You can literally drag it onto the canvas. So it is easy enough to do, but maybe they don't want to, okay? And that's fine. So I'm going to show you two different ways of doing this. You could use an animal. So you go to media and you could go for, I don't know, is there a Santa dog? Santa dog. I feel there should be. There is. So I could put a Santa dog head on here. Oh, this guy, look at him. He definitely suits this jumper. So I'm going to bring that Santa dog in. Remove the background. There it is. Now, we do want to use the eraser brush to just keep the head and kind of neck. Okay. So I'm going to go to erase. And again, I'm not using the quick selection, because if you use the quick selection, let me show you what happens. It'll kind of automatically boosh. There we go. And it's just deleted a bit of its head. Okay. So the quick selection is great if you want to kind of get rid of a background. But if you want to be specific and kind of shave something off, then use the circle brush. Okay. And again, I tell you what, let's click done. Let's make my dog really massive so you can see what I'm doing. Right. Let's do that again. Erase. Right. So I want the circle brush and size. I'll keep the size quite small for a minute, and let's just make some broad sweeps first of all. Right. I definitely want to get rid of all of that. So we'll do that first of all, bring up the brush size, and now I can just quite confidently get rid of all of this stuff at the bottom. All right, now I want to tidy up kind of around the dog's chin. So to do that, like I did in that first activity I showed you, I'll bring the size down a bit, but I'll bring the hardness right down. And now when I'm doing this, there we go, I'll bring the hardness down even more. I want that edge to be really... There we go, that edge I wanted. And sometimes it helps if the size of the brush is quite big and the hardness is down. Having a big brush can sometimes help you get a really soft. That's exactly what I want. Okay, so using a big brush with the hardness all the way down really helps you to shave that off. So these tools are powered by Photoshop. So if you're not familiar with Adobe, Adobe make a well-known piece of software called Photoshop, which is kind of the industry standard app that you'd use for any kind of professional photo editing. And some of the tools from Photoshop have come straight into Express. Things like remove background and this. So it's, you know, it's definitely kind of the nicest place that you've got access to for doing that kind of photo editing. Right, there we go, I can't talk on there. I don't know, hit the jumper, just makes it. Right, so I got my dog on there. Now, you saw me do that with my head earlier, right? And I could just bring in again a Santa hat like I showed you earlier. So I'm not gonna do that again with mine. You know how to do it. It's the same skill, isn't it? Remove the background, then use the circle brush. Make the brush as big as possible, bring the hardness right down, and just shave off the bottom there so that it sits nicely on this jumper. Right. I think let's go one further. We want the dog to be holding something Christmassy. So let's search for, let's go into elements, into the design assets this time. This is for a candy cane. Candy cane. Great. Grab one of these. There it is. Now, again, I could have used the photo and removed the background. But if you know you're going to be removing the background, it's always worth having a look in the design assets, because they're already cut out for you. And they're kind of made for layering stuff up like we're doing right now. Right. Now, then, pro tip. I wanted to look as if he's holding that. So I need to see his thumb. Dogs don't have thumbs. Well, they don't wear jumpers either. Well, I have seen some crazy people putting jumpers on dogs. So, right, let's duplicate this mitten over here. There we go. So I got this spare mitten. And you're like, why are you doing that? Let's bring this spare mitten right to the front. Okay, and I want to use this to make a thumb. So this, all I'm going to do is bring it down in size, and pop it on my candy cane. And there we go. My Santa dog is now Santa dog in a box. It's a very niche combo. My Santa dog in a box is now holding on to that candy cane with a thumb just made out of two circles. You know, just simple design ideas. Okay, now then, let's finish this off. Let's get this done. Now, I'd like my background to be more Christmassy. So let's just, in the design assets, let's search for, because the design assets have got loads of different kind of patterns and overlays and really cool stuff like that. So you could search again in here for maybe something like Argyle. Here we go. So you've got all of these. But I've already used Argyle on the sweater. So what about something like Fair Isle? Let's try that. Oh, we got five of those. And they are wonderful. Right. So, I mean, I can't pick. I cannot pick. I'm going to have to pick, but I can't. They're amazing. I like this one. So let's click on that. Notice again that it's, you see, it's got transparency built into it because it's a design asset. Okay, it's not a photo. It's a design asset. So it's actually kind of got some transparency in there. So let's just bring it up to size. And I only need to come down to the bottom of the box. I don't need it to fill my whole page. I'll show you why in a little bit now. So there we go. That's fine. And now, as you probably guessed, I need that to go right to the back. So in my layer stack, I'm just going to grab that, drag it down to the bottom. Great. I love it, but it is way too strong. So let's bring the opacity of that Fair Isle pattern down. And sometimes you don't know how far down you need to bring them. Okay. So and a lot of people will just say, oh, I'll just put it at 50% then. And that's probably fine. But actually, I think that's too strong. So when I'm using the opacity slider, what I do is I tell my learners, don't bring it down from 100, bring it up from 0. So take it down to 0 so you don't see it, and then bring it in to taste. And you'll notice that the point that you actually want it at is way lower than you ever thought it would be. So for me, I'm really happy with that Fair Isle pattern at an opacity of 17%. So if I'd have started at 100% and brought it down, I no way I'd have gone down as far as 17%. I'd have hit 50, maybe I'd have kept going a bit. And then once you reach kind of 40%, you'd be like, oh, surely that's low enough. But it's not. Okay, right. I'm nearly finished with this. Man, I've had fun doing this. Right. And what I'm going to do now is I just need a message at the bottom. Okay. So I'm going to click on text. And add your text. Here we go. Here's my text box. And let's just type in here, just ring in, see what I did there, to say, and then I'm going to hit return to go to the next line. Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas! Exclamation mark. Right. So that's fine. Fine. But it's not great, is it? So I'd like Merry Christmas to be as wide as the just popping in to say. I'd like the Merry Christmas font to be bigger so that it kind of fills the width of this box. So you could do that manually by selecting it, changing the font size, blah, 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 blah. But we've got a text layout that'll do it for you. It's called the dynamic text layout. And there it is, it's done. It does capitalize it. So if you don't want it to capitalize it, tough. You'd have to do it by changing the font size. But I love that because it's a really cool effect when you've got every line is the same. Oh, I got a – oh, sorry, just missed a comment. Hi, Suzanne. Never used Adobe before. This has been great. Oh, brilliant. Snow globe with P6. Wondering if there's a function for learners to paste in a character or setting description to create an image. Well, it's as if I set Suzanne up with that question, isn't it? Because it's a perfect question, and the answer is yes. On the left-hand side, under media, where we've been searching for photos, where I search for the dog and the Argyle jumper and that red Christmas pattern, if you can't find something you want, or if they've been writing their own prompts, you can actually use AI to generate images. So if I can click on generate image there, you choose what size you want it to be, because this is going to be a brand new image. And then you can paste in whatever you want in here. Okay, so I could have said something like a tartan fabric in Christmas colors, something like that. And you can do whatever you want there. You choose where you want it to look like a photo, like a piece of art. You can use different techniques. There we go, something like that. I'll tick those two, generate, and then it's going to give you four results based on that. So yeah, if they've been creating their own character, you could create a character instead of having that crazy dog. You could create a character. And then once you've got that, oh, look at those. Those are amazing. I love those. And once you've got those, then bring them in. So I could have used that. I could have used AI to make that box, couldn't I, instead of searching for the image. That would have been nice. Well done, Suzanne. You should work for Adobe instead of me. So, yeah, you've got AI built in to Express, and it's a really nice way for them to bring their writing, their ideas to life. So if they've been working on character descriptions recently, why not get their character popping out of a jack-in-a-box? That'd be really cool. Right, just popping in to say Merry Christmas. That's done. I don't like the font at all. So you do have recommended fonts, which, again, will look at the images and the words that you've got in your image and use AI to suggest fonts. So again, it should be, and it is, isn't it? It's suggesting kind of Christmassy fonts for me, which is nice. Suggesting kind of things that work. I like this one. That's nice. So I'm going to go with that. Now then, let's get a different color behind there. So you remember how we've used a rectangle to make those sleeves? Let's just grab a rectangle again. So I'm going to go to shapes, grab a rectangle. There it is. I like the green is great. So I'm going to pop that in there and just fill the bottom there. Brilliant. This needs to go to the back. Well, it doesn't need to go to the back, but it definitely needs to go behind my text. So let's just drag that behind the text. Black text on a dark green background? I don't think so. Let's change the color of my text then to click on here on the fill color. I could go for white, but you know what? This kind of beige that I got in the background is nice. So I'm going to keep that. And maybe I'm going to bring up an outline as well. Bring up the outline around the text and choose. I haven't used this dark brown yet, so that could be nice. Yes. Or maybe the red. No, I like that dark brown. Or this gray. Yeah, there's some kind of a bit of an off gray. No, I'm going to go with the brown. Wonderful. And maybe you'd pop your name somewhere as well. But that is how we would make a jack-in-the-box from scratch. Now, again, that, you know, you're definitely going to have to lead that more, aren't you? But I think that learners find it especially delightful when they've made something like this from scratch. Hi, Mrs. Gray. I think I just noticed your hand going up, I think, and I hope it hasn't been up for ages. But yeah, if you want to pop a question, if you want to switch your microphone on, or if you want to pop it in the chat, whatever you prefer. Sorry, was it hand was an accident? Oh, that's fine. That always happens to me as well. Don't worry about it. Thank you. So many ideas. Yeah, you don't have to give me a compliment just because you accidentally put your hand up. It's fine. No, thanks very much. Yes, I hope they will. And I hope you can see as well where you've got options here. Because, you know, that's what our job is. Our job is to help you guys to use tech. And hopefully to use tech in a way that makes your job easier as well. So, you know, you've got different options here. You know, if you've got time and you know, you'd probably really enjoy doing this kind of jack-in-the-box thing as well, right? So if you've got time, then take them through something like this from scratch. But if you are off your feet at the moment, which I'm sure you are, then, you know, those templates and those guided activities are great. And you know, also maybe don't tell them which guided activity to do. You know, just lead them to, tell them log into Express. And then on the homepage, I want you to click on that view all button there. And guys, I want you to pick one of these guided activities. And then at the end of it, I'm going to make a digital portfolio webpage, which displays all of your work. And how cool would it be if your whole class, you know, two or three have done this, rather than having, you know, 30 snow globes, which is cool, but it's also, you know, them choosing which activity they want to do. There's a lot of power in that, that self-determination, because obviously if they've chosen what they are going to do, then you've got them engaged, haven't you? They are engaged in that. they've got skin in the game. They've chosen it, so they're going to want it to succeed even more. Just an idea. So hopefully that's given you a few different ideas of things that you can do this Christmas. Remember that we're also doing live lessons, okay? We've got 4 live lessons coming up. You can get to those by going to the Express links, short link. If you're familiar with our YouTube channel, it's Dom Trainers. So Dom is my colleague I was mentioning earlier. And on the live there, you can see basically what we've got coming up. Here we go. We've got the 4th. So that is this Thursday, right? No, Wednesday. It's Wednesday. It says Wednesday there, for goodness sake. Wednesday at 1:30, we'll be doing 2 different activities. Then on the 10th, Tuesday the 10th, we'll be doing the same 2 activities. So don't come to both of those. But then the following week, so on the 12th, Thursday the 12th, and then on the Wednesday the 18th, we'll be doing theme 2, which is 2 different activities. Okay, so we've got a theme 1 live lesson and a theme 2 live lesson that we're repeating both of them. So come along to 1 or 2 of those. If you fancy joining in live, it's always fun when we have our live lessons. Otherwise, just, you know, come along to the challenge page, help yourself, or use those challenges built into Express. Right, I'm going to stop there. If there's any questions at all, I know I'm 2 minutes over. Sorry, guys. If you've got any questions, please fire away in the chat. Happy to answer. My email address is there as well in the chat, meredithj@adobe.com. So if you've got any questions.